Raise your hand to the Lord. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for your promises that will never fail. Thank you for our brothers and sisters, for everyone here. Lord, we pray you put victory in everybody's life in Jesus' name. Any arrow, any attack of the devil, quench it, cancel it, break it, destroy it, and keep your people free in Jesus' name. Confirm miracle in every life today. In Jesus' name I pray. And everybody said, Amen. God bless you. I said, God bless you. Thank you very much. You can sit down. Today we're going into the Word of God and we're looking at Ephesians again. Ephesians chapter 6. And the verse we're looking at today is verse 16. Above all, taking the shield of faith, wherewith you shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked. As you look at this verse of scripture, and it says, above all, that is, it's been talking about different pieces of the armor of the Christian soldier. And now he comes to this and he says, above all. Which means, this is one you must not forget. This is one you must hold on to. This is one you must jealously guard. This is one above all, beyond all, on top of them all. Take the shield of faith. You know, he could have said just that, take the shield of faith. But then he's saying, taking the shield of faith. What's the difference between take the shield of faith and then taking the shield of faith? It means keep on taking it. Keep on taking it. You wake up in the morning, before you go out, take it. You come back and then you meet another challenge at home, take it. And then your wife has not had a child, then you remember that if you only believe all things are possible, take it. And then your wife is pregnant and the pregnancy is being threatened, take it. And then you are in the ministry, it appears that you might fail, you might fall, take it. Taking, taking, taking the shield of faith, wherewith ye shall be able, you will be able. Now, listen to this. Out of mouth is out of mind. I know what you normally say. We normally say, out of sight is out of mind. But I'm going to tell you this. Out of mouth is out of mind. Let me say it another way. What you express is what you impress. What you express with your mouth is what you impress on your mind. When you say, I am not able, you impress that on your mind. What you express is what you impress. You impress negativity into your mind, into your subconscious. I am weak. You express it, you impress it. I am not able. You express it, you impress it. What you express with your mouth is what you impress on your mind. But out of mouth is out of mind. Cut it out of your mouth. Never say again, I am not able, because you are able. I said you are able. You never know what you can do until you rise up and do it. I was reading about a woman, 75 years of age. She had a son. The son is in the 50s, about 51, 52. And the son was repairing a car in the garage of the house. And then the jack got used and that fell on the man. And the man screamed out. And then the woman, 75 years of age, and the scream of her son. And there was nobody in the around in the community. And the woman, 75 years of age, seen the feet of the legs of the sun sticking out, and the car on that sun. The woman bent down, lifted up that car, and the sun came out. After the woman did that, then people came around and said, "Can you do it again?" "No, I cannot do it again." Why? At that time when she saw the challenge, the blood ran into the right place, and they call it the adrenal, and then ran, and then all of a sudden a surge of strength, a surge of energy and power came into her, and she lifted up that vehicle because she wanted to save the life of her son. Many things you think you cannot do, when the challenge comes, you will do it. Don't ever let the devil hear it from your mouth that you are not able. You are able. I said you are able. You will whip the devil. You will destroy the devil. The power of God be mighty in your life in Jesus' name. Wherewith ye shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked. You will do it. Faith for permanent victory. You will have victory. Every day victory. Every time victory. Permanent victory you will have in Jesus' name. Number one, the shield and protection of faith. The shield and protection of faith. Number two, the strength and the power of faith. The strength, the power of faith. Number three, the sufficiency and the possibilities of faith. The sufficiency and the possibilities of faith. Number one, the shield of faith. Isn't that what the Bible says here? It says above all, taking the shield of faith. Taking the shield of faith. What's the shield used for? Well, just that word is very clear. To shield away something. To shield away evil. To shield away attack. To shield away affliction. To shield away a curse. To shield away the arrow of the enemy in your life. They will never catch you again. In 1 Chronicles chapter 12, I'm reading from verse 8. And the Gadites there separated themselves unto David into the hold, to the wilderness, men of might and men of war, fit for the battle, that could handle shield and buckler, that could handle shield and buckler. And then it says, whose faces were like the faces of lions, and were as sweet as the rose upon the mountains. It tells us these were men of war, valiant men, mighty men, courageous men. And it says, one of the pieces of armor that they had is a shield, and they knew how to handle the shield. Actually, Paul the apostle was making use of the Roman soldier. And you see, the Roman soldiers, they were strapped to their hand the shield of iron or the shield of brass. And then when they throw the arrow at them, instead of striking them, they will defend themselves with a shield. Have you seen those anti-riot policemen? And they come into a particular community where there's rioting. And then they hold the shield because they know that some of those rioters will be throwing stones at them, broken bottles at them. But they have learned how to use the shield to shield themselves, to protect themselves from the attack and from all the things that they be throwing at them. Now, what shield do you even have? Let me show you the shield we have in Genesis chapter 15. Genesis chapter 15, reading from verse 1. After these things, the word of the Lord came unto Abraham in a vision, saying, "Fear not, Abram, I am thy shield, and thine exceeding great reward. I am thy shield." No wonder all the property of Abraham, God shielded him. And all the children of Abraham, God shielded them. And the wife of Abraham, God shielded her. And Abraham himself, God shielded him. And God protected him. The shield and the protection of faith. God said, I am thy shield. Do you know that the Almighty God is your shield? He will not allow any attack to come upon your life. He will not allow affliction to come upon your life. As they are coming, before they come, he knew that they will be coming. Therefore, he will come and shield you here. And he will shield you on the right hand. He will shield you on the left hand. He will shield you in the front. He will shield you behind. And underneath you are the everlasting arms. And then he tells us in Deuteronomy chapter 33. Deuteronomy chapter 33. And I'm reading from verse 27. Deuteronomy 33, verse 27. The eternal God is thy refuge. Did you go to sleep? I said the eternal God is your refuge. Underneath are the everlasting arms. He shall thrust out thine the enemy from before thee. He will do it. If you wanted to do it, you couldn't do it properly, and you couldn't do it completely, the Almighty God will crush and conquer your enemies. He shall thrust out the enemy from before thee, and shall say, destroy them. Israel then shall dwell in safety, and alone the fountain of Jacob shall be upon a land of coin and wine. Also, the heaven shall drop down dew. The Lord will refresh you. And the Lord will refill you. Every time that your bucket or your bottle or your cup is running dry, the dew of heaven will send rain upon you again. Happy art thou, O Israel, who is like unto thee, O people, saved by the Lord, the shield of thy help. He is your shield. Those enemies will not catch you. And they will not crush you. All the time take with you the shield of faith, the shield of thy help, who is the sword of thy excellency. Thine enemy shall be found liars unto thee, and thou shalt tread upon the high places. It tells us in Psalm 3. Psalm 3, I'm reading from verse 1. Psalm 3, reading from verse 1. Lord, how are they increased that trouble me? Many are they that rise up against me. You know, when you think about the life of David, something surprises you. If you put David on the one hand, and you put Saul on the other hand, and you say, who has more enemies, David or Saul? David or Saul? David. Who was more valiant, David or Saul? Who was more courageous, David or Saul? Who was more promoted, David or Saul? Who was more exalted, David or Saul? Because God was a shield. Even though he had enemies, God shielded him. And even the other fellow that didn't appear to have too many enemies, what did he make in life? Never think that because you have enemies, you will not make it in life. If God is shielding you from those enemies, you will make it. In fact, you have made it already. It's like, you know, they have issued your certificate, but it is still in the office. But they have issued it. And there's nothing they can do about it. And nobody can change it. And your name is there already. And then when we come and we say, you have succeeded already. And you are exalted already. And you are passed already. And you are promoted already. Then you say, but it is not in my hand. What does that mean? But it's in the office over there. And then you just walk there. You say, are you begging them? It's your own. You say, I come. What did you come for? Look at my face. Look at my energy, identity card. And look at my name. Bring my certificate there. And you know, over there, because they're looking for bribe, they say, they cannot see the fire. Never mind, they will find it out. Because of the court of heaven, they will never lose your fire. And you are promoted already. You see, David, even though the enemies were there, the Lord had said, I promoted you, don't worry. I am your shield, and I'm the power, I'm the strength of your protection. In verse 2, many there be which say, of my soul. There is no help for him in God, but thou, O Lord, art a shield for me, my glory, and the lifter up of mine head. That's what I told you, you've got it already. Psalm 91. In Psalm 91, here is your privilege. And here is what the Lord has for you. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High. Who is that person? It's me now. I said it's me. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God. In Him will I trust. Surely He shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. He shall cover thee with His feathers, and under His wings shalt thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and thy buckler. And when you are shielded, when the shield is there, what's the implication? Verse 5, thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flies by day, nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor for the destruction that wasteth at noonday. 1,000 shall fall at thy side. Now, when those people begin to fall, don't say, maybe it will be my turn next. It will never be your turn. Remember, what you express is what you impress. Remember, what comes out of your mouth is what takes hold of your mind. And remember, out of mouth is out of mind. If it is not in your mouth, you say, that negative language.